What is good, everybody? It is your boy, Say My Name Soldier, coming at you with a schedule set times review for Base Canyon Year 5. In the second half of this video, I will also be providing updated information for the festival guide video that I did a few weeks ago. If you checked out that video, I appreciate it. I got a lot of really good feedback that it was very helpful. So now that the map for the festival and the campground has dropped, I'm going to provide some updated information on like bathrooms, water station, and updated policies for the festival campgrounds, like when you get there, them searching your car and all that stuff. So I'm going to be going over all of that with you. This is kind of like a part two for my year five festival guide. But before we get into that, I'm going to be going over the schedule slash set times with you, showing you all the sets that I'm going to be planning on seeing. And if y'all want to come rage with me, have a great time, spread that love and high energy, you will know what sets I will be at and what sets I won't be at. So without further ado, let's get right into this. So for day one, let me open the Base Canyon app. All right, so for Base Canyon, I think it was 2019 was when they added the hilltop stage. At the time, it was the second stage. That year, I saw AU5 and Benda at that stage. The following year, 2021, I decided to stay at the main stage for the whole weekend. Base Canyon, for me, is not a festival that I want to be going to these other stages because I love the main stage so much. And also, I try my best to hold the same spot so that I don't lose it. So this year, I doubt I will be leaving the main stage to go see some of these other sets that I would like to see at the other stages. That can change. You know, if I have homies that are at the main stage holding down our spot and they're like, we're going to be here, we're not going to leave, and I feel like going and maybe splitting a set and going to the other stages, I just might do that. But I'm going to go over the sets that I am most likely going to see. Like I said, staying at the main stage for pretty much the whole weekend. So starting off on Friday, we got Whales at 3 p.m. That is really cool, starting it off with a banger. And then at 3:50, we have Stone Level. Super stoked for that. I'm pretty sure Stone Level opened up day two or day three main stage last year. And so I'm just excited that he got, even if it's a little bit later, it's a later time slot, a little bit louder, hopefully, and excited for that. At 4:35, we have the Yookie Brothers. Shout out the Yookie Brothers. They are dope. Conflicting with that set is Francis Durrell at the Starlight stage. I definitely wanted to see Francis Durrell. I have not seen him yet, but again, that's around 4. Around 4:30 is when the pit starts getting packed and, you know, space starts filling up. And if you leave your spot, that's around the time where somebody's going to snag it and you're not really going to get it back. So most likely going to stay at the main stage for Yookie. And then at 5:20, we have Ray Volpe. Big ups to Ray Volpe. It's been awesome seeing his rise. And I am very excited for his set. I have recorded his sets at Base Canyon in years past. By the way, in the description of this video, I will provide a link for the part one of the Year 5 Festival Guide. If you have not checked out that video, as well as the playlist for all the other Base Canyons that I have ever done, that will be in the description of this video so that you can check those videos out. At 6:10, we have Funk Case. Big ups to Funk Case. It's dope to have him back. I saw him at EDC this year. That set was disgusting. It was amazing. If you haven't seen that video, it is in my EDC 2023 playlist. Go ahead and check that out. That set is conflicting with Point Blank, which is at 6:20 at the Starlight stage. That's one of those sets where, you know, I would like to see maybe like the first 30 minutes of Funk Case and then maybe go to Point Blank. So again, if I have homies holding down the Say My Name Soldier spot, then I might be able to split that set, but most likely I'm going to stay for Funk Case's entire set, even though I really want to see Point Blank again. I saw him at Forbidden Kingdom last year and with a back-to-back, and it was super good. I definitely want to see a full set from him, but, you know, we'll see. At 7 p.m., we have Champagne Drip. Big ups to Champagne Drip. Awesome to have him back. He has played Bass Kangen in years past. And, you know, I love the Wakan vibe. I love Champagne Drip's music. It's melodic. He's got some stompy in there, some experimental. Champagne Drip at 7 p.m. is a very good vibe. You are not going to want to miss that set. He is conflicting with Resurrect at 7. Resurrect starts at 7:10, and he is at the Starlight stage. I definitely have been wanting to see Resurrect, but again, 7 p.m., leaving the spot at the main stage, probably not something I'm going to do, but we'll see. Definitely planning on seeing a Champagne Drip set. And this is a big one. So for those of you that don't know, Diesel was not able to make it to Bass Kangen this year. So Riot 10 was already in the lineup. Crank Dat got added, and they are doing a back-to-back. I am so unbelievably fucking stoked for this set. Crank Dat has been at the top of my list of artists that I want to see. I have not seen yet. He's going back-to-back with Riot 10. It's going to be nasty. Riot 10 had a dope set last year. Riot 10 has been killing it the last couple years. So I am very, 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 very excited to see Crank Dat. Big ups to him. That back-to-back is going to be disgusting. So much fun. 7:50 p.m. main stage. Up next at the Kangen stage, we have Kill the Noise back-to-back Trivecta at 8:40 p.m. Definitely going to be there for that. And then we got Wooly at 9:30 p.m. main stage. Sudden Death at 10:30. And then the Excision set at 11:40. That's most likely going to be an hour and 20 minute, maybe an hour and 30 minute set, possibly. But he definitely will go longer than an hour, even if it's just a little bit over an hour. All right, that is it for Friday. Before we move on to Saturday, I just want to give you my reaction to how that whole day is stacked up, and it is incredible. This is a dope day one. Let's just start from the beginning. I mean, starting off with Wales, Stone Level, Yuki, and Ray Volpe, that is just a dope way to start day one. High energy, I love it, I'm excited for that. And then we got Funk Case, Champagne Drip, and then the Dog Eat Dog, Crank Dat back-to-back, Riot 10, Kill the Noise back-to-back, Trivecta. I mean, this is just like a hard and then some melodic and some vibes. It's just a very well-structured day one. 9:30, so at 9:30 Wooly, 10:30 Sudden Death, and then Excision. That is incredible. That is just going to be so, it's going to be so sick. Wooly, Sudden Death, Excision. That is just a dope final three sets for day one. That is going to be incredible. I believe Sudden Death played before Excision. I can't remember. Maybe I'm thinking of a different festival. But anyways, this is going to be great. This is a great way to top off Friday. All right, so now let's move on to Saturday. We are starting off with Emorphic at 3 p.m. main stage, and then Grabitz at the main stage 3:50 p.m. 4:40 p.m. Zingara, 5:30 p.m. Taboo, 6:20 p.m. Company back to back Calcium. That set is going to be awesome. They went back to back at the main stage 2021. That was a super fun set. I believe that set was earlier in the day, so now we get a little bit later set for the Company back-to-back Calcium set this year, so that's going to be cool. I'm pretty sure on that. I'm pretty sure they had a little bit earlier set last time. Not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure this one's a little bit later, which is cool because that is right before sunset, I'm pretty sure. And then Dion Timmer at 7:10 p.m. Dion Timmer in years past, I think 2019, his set was at sunset, and that was super cool. Dion Timmer has, you know, he's got all the really cool heavy songs, very unique sound design, and he throws in some melodic in there too, which I think is awesome. He is conflicting with Dubscribe. So 7 p.m. Dion Timmer conflicting with Dubscribe. Dubscribe is at the Starlight stage. I definitely have been wanting to see Dubscribe. He's been on the rise. He has so many songs rinsed by Excision. But again, around 7 p.m., leaving the main stage, probably going to end up staying for Dion Timmer. And then at 8 p.m., we got Space Laces, one of my favorite artists. ATLEN's at 8:50. Sullivan King at 9:45. Liquid Stranger at 10:40. And then to Headline day two, we got Muff and Grizz. Hell yeah. Super stoked that Grizz is headlining day two. If you watched my Bass Canyon lineup review for this year, I had a prediction that Grizz was going to be playing this year, but even I couldn't have predicted that he'd be headlining day two. I think that this is a dope way to end day two. It's a different vibe from Subtronic's headlining day two last year, and it's also different from the other headliners that have headlined for day two in the past. Year one, year two, it was Zomboy. So Excision does a really good job of year over year, 18 to 19, 19 to 21, 21 to 22, 22 to 23, creating a different vibe from day one to day two, day two to day three. So I would say majority of the time in years past, it's like day one and day two go super hard. Day three typically has throughout the day more relaxed, more chill, still really fun sets, but not as hard as day one and day two. For instance, you know, Boogie T playing on day three, artists like that, Dirt Monkey, you know, the wobbly, the wonky. So this year, day two is more of like the, during the day, more of like a vibe and wobble, wonk, Wakan kind of vibe to it, headlining with Grizz. Grizz is still a very fun, high energy set with the sax and the dubstep, and he throws in some rhythm, he'll throw in some doubles. It's just more of like a happy, feelsy vibe for the headline day two. And like I said, I think that that is cool that year over year, it's a different experience for day two. So overall, you know, just starting off at the beginning of Saturday, Emorphic, Starting Hard, into Grabbits. Grabbits, I haven't seen a festival set in a long time, and so I'm not sure what to expect from his set. You know, he definitely makes dubstep, but I have an idea that it would be more of like a melodic dubstep kind of vibe. And then into Zingara. I'm a little bit familiar with Zingara's music. You know, it gives me a Wakan vibe, very experimental, deep wub, not, you know, aggressive, stompy dubstep. So Grabbits into Zingara, into Taboo. You know, for a couple hours, it, you know, we kind of chill out for a little bit, more vibes, people are getting into the festival, and, you know, they're walking up the hill, and, you know, it's not stompy, aggressive dubstep. Like I said, it's more like that Taboo, Zingara, Grabbits kind of vibe, and I think that that is cool. And then around 6:20, right before sunset, is when we start getting into, like, you know, the heavy dubstep company back-to-back, Calcium, Dion Timmer, Space Laces, AT Aliens, Sullivan King. So then we go from more relaxed and chill, and then right back into, you know, more aggressive heavy, and then capping it off back with more like, you know, Wakan, Liquid Stranger, and then Grizz. That's going to be dope. Very excited for day two. I think that is a really cool way to stack the entire lineup. All right. All right, so we're moving on to Sunday, starting off at 3 p.m. with Vastiv, back-to-back Cliptic. That is going to be disgusting. Great way to start off the day. And then at 3:50, Canyon Stage, Versa. Big ups to Versa. I've seen him a few times now. He always throws down. He's got a very unique, you know, DPMO kind of funk case vibe, aggressive, tear out, heavy dubstep, rhythm. It is great, high energy. Don't miss that set. And then at 4:40 p.m., Canyon Main Stage, we got Lays. I saw Lays last year. If you have not seen that video of her set last year, I didn't get the whole thing, just more of like a recap video, but that will be in my Bass Canyon 2022 playlist, link in the description if you want to check it out. Hole is at the main stage this year. I didn't see Hole the last time he played the main stage. Someone corrected me. I'm pretty sure he played at the same time as Kazo, not Subtronic's, but obviously I was it. First of all, Kazo into Subtronic's day two last year was just, like I said, that is a different vibe than what day two will be this year. And yeah, that day two was incredible. Hole was playing at the other stage, so it's awesome that Hole is at the Canyon main stage this year at a really good time slot, 5:30 p.m. That is really dope. At 6:20 p.m., we have Level Up. Level Up has always been killing it. I am a huge fan of all the female dubstep artists. her EDC set this year with Borgor was seriously one of my favorite sets of the whole weekend. It was disgusting. The doubles, the energy the entire time. That back-to-back was so much fun. I think I had more fun at that level up Borgor set than Subtronic set. Subtronic set at EDC this year was really good. I liked the vibe and the kind of set that he played at EDC 2022. It's just a preference thing. Both sets were great, but that level up set, in my opinion, was just one of the best sets of the whole weekend. That back-to-back was just so much fun. So big ups to level up, 6:20 p.m. At 7:10 p.m., we have Knife Party Sunset set. That is conflicting with Muerte, who is playing at the same time at the Starlight stage. I would rather see Muerte again at 7 p.m. If I have homies holding down the spot, I might possibly go to Muerte if I know my spot's going to be, you know, saved. I would like to get at least one or two sets at the other stages. So we'll see. We'll see. Muerte is definitely a heavy set, and I would rather be at that one than Knife Party, which... Not shitting on Knife Party. I like Knife Party. It's just there's just a different vibe there that I would rather be at. And then at 8 p.m. we have Excision Detox conflicting with Sisto. I have wanted to see Sisto for a while. I would definitely like to check out that set, but I do not miss Excision Detox. This is an Excision Festival. Every Excision Festival I've ever gone to, I always go to the Detox. It's just kind of one of those things where I want to see Excision as much as possible. I love the Detox sets. I think they're so much fun. He's always rinsing really dope, you know, nasty, more kind of like down-tempo tunes and hybrid trap and some rhythm that he wouldn't normally play in his, you know, his hour and a half or two-hour live sets. I'm a huge fan of the Detox, so most likely going to stay at the Detox. And if I didn't say the time, that's at 8 p.m. At 8:50 p.m., we have Boogie T back-to-back Dirt Monkey. That's going to be super fun. They have played Bass Canyon in the past. They've both done solo sets. I think Boogie T went back-to-back with Subtronics year one. So they've both had solo sets and back-to-backs at Bass Canyon before. So that'll be a really dope, fun set at 8:50 p.m. The sun will have already gone down mostly, so the visuals will be popping. It'll be really bright. Dirt Monkey uses Incedigris for his most of his visuals. Incedigris has been one of my favorite artists for a long time, very similar to Chris Dyer. Big shout out Chris Dyer. I got this shirt back at Imagine Music Festival in Atlanta, Georgia back in 2016. One of my favorite shirts. All right, and then at 9:40 p.m., we have BTSM. The BTSM 2021 set was so crazy. It was one of the best sets of the whole weekend. Super excited for the BTSM set. All right, and then after BTSM at 9:40, we have the, at 10:50 p.m., Excision back-to-back, most likely Subtronics. You know, there's been some... rumors going around about who it's actually going to be. It's most likely Subtronics. Turn that shit up. You know, that's going to be a crazy set. I don't want to talk about it too much because it's just, I mean, I could just talk for 20 minutes about what to expect from that set. But yeah, it's going to be great. All right. So that is my reaction, you know, just to kind of go over day three. Vastive Cryptic, Versa, Lays, Hole, Level Up. So it's going to be disgusting, heavy dubstep until 7 o'clock. And then we got the Knife Party Sunset set. Excision Detox kind of bring the tempo down a little bit. And then Boogie T back-to-back Dirt Monkey. And then bring it back up. Finish off day three with High Energy BTSM into the Excision back-to-back Subtronics. So... day three is definitely the higher energy day in comparison to day two. But this, the way that this festival is structured this year in comparison to years past, like I said, it's a lot different and I'm really excited for it. Day one, go hard. Day two, a little bit more mellow, but finish off strong. And day three is just going to be nasty. So. Very much excited for how this the set times and everything line up. It's going to be a lot of fun. All right, so the next thing I'm going to be going into is basically a part two for my Base Canyon Year 5 festival guide. I'm going to be providing updated info, accurate location for water stations, bathrooms, and just correct some of the info from my last video. And, you know, updated festival and campground information and policies. So we're going to be getting into all of that. All right, so let me pull up. I have the maps on my phone. If you didn't get this email, they sent a picture of the, because it's not on the app yet, but they have the, it will be soon. I mean, we're a couple days out. The camping map, as well as the festival map. So all the locations for everything, that is in an email that they sent out, and that's what I'm going to be referencing to be providing updated information on everything. Holy shit, this video is already 20 minutes. Jesus. All right, I'll try to make this not super long. All right, so here we have the festival grounds. So let's just start when you walk in, okay? So here's the road, or we'll start at the general store. Here's the main general store. You follow this road down. This is the will call slash box office if you need to pick up your wristbands. This is the entrance. You walk in the entrance. You scan your wristband. There's this pond off to the right, and it looks like they put a water station, I'm pretty sure, like right here is what it looks like on the map. So as soon as you walk in, hit that water station, get it out of the way, and then the merch is off to the left. Right here, the Base Canyon and artist merch off to the left. So this is a nice area to go ahead and get started with your day, get water, get in line, get some merch out of the way, throw it in your locker. And then it looks like there's like a, you know, like a shade thing right here. And let's see, VIP restrooms are around this area right here where the food vendors are. And then there's also alcohol right here. In my last video, I said there was a water station right here, but like I said, it looks like they put it a little bit further back right here, basically right by the merch, which is smart. And then there's also, so this is the Hilltop stage. And they tuck bathrooms back in here to the right of this stage, it looks like. I don't know if they had that in years past, but they are showing restrooms. Maybe it's like right here, but in this general area to the right of the stage. Cool. And this whole area is food vendors, and then they have, you know, other merchandise vendors. Not the festival merchandise, but you know what I'm talking about. Like all the different companies that set up their booths and stuff. Those will be right here. The lockers are right here in this white building. All right, so I'm going to update some info. So I didn't say, but they did have bathrooms right here last year. So bathrooms here, porta potties, and then they also put a water station right here. I don't think they had that in years past. Maybe they did, but there's a water station right here. And then also in the last video, there's still a water station right here. So when you're on the hill, you can either hit the water station right here or you can go off to the left. I personally would use the water station that I've talked about before in my last video right here, because if you're meeting up with people there, you're getting water, you're doing whatever, you're still able to like look out at the hill, and it is a really cool spot to do that. When you hit this water station right here, you're not leaving far from the hill, the grass area, but you're not able to see the stage anymore. So that doesn't make a huge difference either way. I'm pretty sure these buildings right here is just alcohol. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure it's just alcohol. I don't know if they serve food right here. Who knows? Okay. So, yep, water station over here. Already covered that in the last video, and in years past, they have had porta potties right here. I don't know if they will this year because it's not on the map. So maybe they got rid of them right here so it doesn't smell like piss and shit when you're walking by. I don't know yet. Like I said, there's not an indicator on the map that there's restrooms right here because they added restrooms right here. So not only are there restrooms right here, which is more towards the alcohol and food vendors, but they added one right here by the water station. So you don't have to maybe walk as far. So bathrooms right here, water stations right here, and it doesn't show any porta potties right here. So just know that when you're on the hill, if you're right here in my area, instead of going off to the right for restrooms, just come up here to the hill, the top of the hill. Cool. And the last video, I said that there is food right here. There is also a water station and then VIP drinks. So that info is all the same. Right here, this is important. I don't know if they had this in years past, but it is showing right here at the bottom of this pathway. So there's this raised platform. Here's the walkway that goes across. You can take this walkway all the way down instead of going around right here. So at the end of this walkway where the ADA wheelchair accessibility is, it is showing the med tent. So if you get injured, if you need medical assistance of any kind in this whole area, go right here. Like I said, this is a raised platform. I said that this was VIP in my last video. I don't think it's VIP because it's not showing VIP. So maybe I got that wrong, but this is a raised platform either way. And so if you're in the pit area, you need to go around this way. Boom, there's a med tent. It's important to know that. Make sure your friends know that. It's important that you are aware of where you need to go in an emergency. Like I said, this is wheelchair accessibility. In the last video, I said that this whole area was VIP. It's not. It's just this front area. You see where you see these lines? It's kind of like the steps or whatever, the grass steps. It's just this area for VIP. And then also it looks like the back section right here is VIP, but that's it. In between there should be GA accessible. That's what it's showing on the map. And that makes sense from what they did in years past. It looks like there's also VIP restrooms right here near the platform. So if you have VIP, you don't need to hit any of those other spots. You can just hit the bathrooms right here. VIP drinks are also right here. And it looks like food is right here. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm seeing food on the map right there. Okay, so there is up here at the top of the hill, there is food. Okay, because it's showing that on the map. So there's food right here as well as alcohol. It's also showing food right here. Okay, that makes sense. I think I remember that now. Blue building, food, food here, alcohol here. Cool. Just want to make sure I give you the most accurate info possible. By this platform, there's some more food. And this, so in the last video, I said this, I just had like my orientation wrong. Don't worry about anything over here. There's nothing over here. Right here, this is where the starlight stage is, as well as bathrooms, and we're gonna go over all of that. So for a reference point, this platform that you'll see, so here's the walkway for the grass area, the platform, and then over here is all, you know, the lockers and the food and everything. So the starlight stage is right here, this whole grass area. And they face the stage so that the sunset is in the background instead of facing the other way. It's a good idea to have it that way. And then also it helps with a lot of the sound bleed. If you face the stage the other way and it's back over here, then the sound's coming this way. And then all the people that are on the hill are hearing the other stage. You're still, okay, listen. If you are in this area, whether you're in VIP, on the hill, you are going to hear this other stage, the starlight stage. There will be sound bleed. You can't get rid of it. Even if the stage is faced the other way, you're going to be hearing the other stage, okay? So my recommendation, if you're on the hill, I know it's kind of cool to be on this side of this, you know, here's the stage. If you're on the right side of this grass area in this area, you can see the canyon a little bit better, but you're going to be hearing the other stage. My recommendation is just stay as center with the stage as possible. That way you're not hearing the other stage as much. There have been times where I've been like up here and I can hear that other stage, no problem. And you don't want that unless you're by the stage. Okay, bathrooms. So there should, yes. So this area right here is the bathrooms. In the last video I said they were over here. It's not, they're right here. I just had my orientation wrong. It's kind of hard looking at this map from a bird's eye view. This shows a med tent. I don't know if that's an actual med tent. It doesn't, oh yeah, it says, okay, on the map. Okay, so this is another med tent. I said that this was like a small and festival general store. Somebody corrected me and said that it's not anymore. Maybe it still is. Who knows? Okay, so bathrooms here, starlight stage. There's a shade if you need it, shade area right here. There's an area back in here called Safe Haven. I'm guessing if you are not doing well up here, you can go over there, kind of chill out, get some assistance if you need it. There's also food right here. Right here it looks like in this area, cool. And this is where they're gonna put the Ferris wheel. It looks like they added another ride in addition to the Ferris wheel. The hilltop stage definitely looks like it's gonna be different this year. I mean, it's different every year, but I think that is everything updated for the festival location. Lockers are here. Get a locker if you can. It's very useful. Know your water stations. Know your med tent locations. Know your bathrooms. All these locations that I just mentioned are good meetup spot, like lockers. Cool. I think that's a majority of the things that I can cover for inside of the festival. If you have issues with your wristband, like it didn't come in the mail, it got lost, this is where you're going to go to get your updated wristband. I think it's $50 if you lose your wristband, if it didn't come in the mail, whatever. This is where you go. And if you lose your wristband throughout the weekend, like you didn't put it on tight enough, it falls off, just go to the box office / will call, pay $50, get a new wristband. No big deal. Okay. So I showed you in the last video, this is the path you take, general store, boom, curves around, take this pathway back to the camping area. Before I get into the updated festival, the camping ground info, I want you to know this. When you leave the festival each day, when the festival is over and you're about to walk back to camping, if you're walking down this road instead of taking the shuttles, because the shuttle lines after the festival's over are really long. It's just quicker to walk back. It's 20 minutes to walk, 25, because you're walking with thousands of people. That is quicker than waiting for the shuttle. If you're like, I don't want to walk, I'd rather wait for the shuttle and not walk, then you're just going to be waiting a little bit longer and then you don't have to walk. Okay, this is what I'm getting at. Imagine thousands of people walking down this road back to camping, and you're behind thousands of people. People are kicking up dirt as they're walking. So this entire mile walk back to camp, you're just breathing in dirt in your mouth, in your throat, in your nose. There are times in the past where I wasn't wearing like a mask or a bandana to cover my face for that walk back. And the next day your throat feels like it feels terrible. Like your throat hurts, your nose hurts. You gotta like blow your nose all morning long. So keep some sort of bandana, a balaclava, something that, you know, a neck gaiter, something like that, maybe a mask, and just throw it on for the walk back. That way, if there's thousands of people walking in front of you and dirt is getting kicked up, you're not breathing in a bunch of dirt. You're only walking a mile. I'm telling you, it will save your throat and your nose by not breathing in all that dirt and all that disgusting crap that's being kicked up on the walk back to camping. I'm telling you, that will help you out the next day. You won't feel shitty the next day. Okay, so in the first video, I covered that this is the small general store right here. This building, I'm pretty sure, was torn down. It was the old one, and then I think this is where the expanded one is. Somebody in my comments said that building got torn down. This building got torn down so they can add the bigger general store. I don't think they tore down the bigger general store, but somebody said they went to Beyond Wonderland and it wasn't there. I don't know. You'll find out when you get there. If you have issues with your camping wristband, this is where you will go, this building right here. And then this is where the shuttle drop-off pickup is supposed to be. And you follow this road. This takes you to the pivot. I covered this in the last video. One of the things I forgot to cover in the last video were the showers. It should be in this area. It should be like right here. Water stations and showers should be in this area, as well as food right here. The vendors are all around here in this half moon. This is where the silent disco should be if they have it. The pivot stage should be in this area on the grass. Things could change. Not too sure. Not 100% sure on that because the map for the camping isn't super accurate. It doesn't have like key locations. I didn't cover really any of the other camp areas last time other than Terrace. So this is Terrace right here. This bottom left corner of this huge circle is Premier. The other three quarters of this circle is, you know, I used to call it GA camping. That's what it used to be called. Now it's called Standard Camping. Same thing. Standard, GA, whatever. And then this circle over here is kind of like if you're arriving late, like early Friday, possibly late Thursday, early Friday, you might be stuffed over here, but I doubt it unless you're like literally one of the last people to arrive. Okay, when you get to Base Canyon, they are going to search your car. Okay, we all know what happened at Beyond Wonderland earlier this year. Okay, I really disliked the articles because the article headliner was like shooting at Beyond Wonderland. It wasn't at the festival, it was at the campgrounds. Okay, so the title of that of the articles really pissed me off, because having a shooting inside of the festival and having a shooting inside the festival campgrounds is two totally different things. It's horrible what happened. Condolences to the lives lost. They are going to be doing an extra thorough search through your car. Okay? Don't have dumb shit on you. Dumb shit includes any glass. Bongs, don't bring them. Bottles of alcohol, if they're glass, don't bring them. They're going to confiscate them. If you're doing bringing alcohol, whatever, do cans, but you cannot have glass of any kind, okay? Like I just said, bongs, maybe even pipes. Like if you're trying to like bring in stuff that you're not supposed to be bringing in, like you can get silicone, you can get stuff that isn't glass. They don't want glass, because imagine this whole area. Imagine like a bottle being broken here and 10 bottles being broken over here and, you know, broken glass. If people step on broken glass, they can get fucked up. Okay, they don't allow glass in the camping area. I'm actually for that. There's no reason to have glass anything. Find other stuff, you know, plastic bottles or stuff. The security check is going to be extra long because of the situation that happened, okay? It is what it is. You get there when you get there. The search through your car, it is what it is. It takes as long as it takes. It's nothing you can control. Try not to be frustrated about it. You know, when people are sitting in a line of traffic to get in here, it can be frustrating if it takes hours. Listen, you made it to Base Canyon. You're there. Be happy, you know. Don't get too stressed out about it. Don't be worried about, you know, gun sniffing dogs, okay? If you don't have anything on you that you shouldn't have, you shouldn't be worried about anything. And what I will say is, if you are bringing in things into your campground area, do your due diligence. You know, don't be stupid. I don't do that stuff anymore. I don't bring in anything I shouldn't. Those days are behind me, so I don't worry about shit. It is what it is, okay? You will be asked to step out of your vehicle so that they can search it, okay? So I don't know for sure, but they shouldn't be searching your person, okay? They're just searching your car, okay? If you're bringing, you're not supposed to bring weed, okay? But, you know, there's vacuum sealed containers. Like I said, do your due diligence. Don't just have a fucking pound of weed in your car, okay? Because you're trying to sell half of it and so that you can have money to buy merch and stuff. Like, just don't do dumb shit, okay? Bring what you need and be smart about it. Don't be dumb. Get there as early as you can. Register your wristband. You might be able to win 5 tickets to the next Base Canyon. Cell service is limited, so take a screenshot of your pre-party ticket so that you can just pull open your photos, and then you can get in without trying to, you know, use your data to pull up your pass, or I'm sorry, your ticket. Like I said, if your wristband gets lost or damaged, $50 to replace it. Just go to will call. IDs, make sure you have your driver's license, some form of government issued ID, passport. If you lost your ID recently or you lose it in the next couple days, go to the DMV, get the piece of paper that goes along with, you know, either your expired ID, that shows that you're in the process of getting a new one. If you lost your ID, you know, go to the DMV, let them know. They'll provide you a piece of paper so that you can get in with that. It just has to be from the DMV. Gates open at 2 p.m. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So from my last video, that information that I provided is correct. If the gates open at 2, there's going to be people lined up at 1 p.m. most likely. Probably not a lot, but some. I'll be one of them. So if you want to be one of the first people walking in, like I have, then, you know, it's just like a ride at Disneyland. You might have to wait an hour so that you can ride a ride that lasts a minute 30, except this ride is going to be 3 days. So, you know, get there early if you don't want to be waiting in long lines just to get in. It says the campgrounds open at 1 p.m. Wednesday, and all campsites must be vacated by 12 p.m. on Monday. The shuttles leaving for the airport after Base Canyon is over, I believe, is 8 p.m. and 10 p.m. 8 a.m. and 10 a.m. So make sure you get the right shuttle if your flight leaves early. My flight leaves at the way late on Monday, so it doesn't really matter for me. I just get there when I get there. Did I cover the other? Oh, so this is Premier Oasis Camping is part of Gold Camping. Oh yeah, Oasis. So this is Gold Camping, and then off to the left, this is Oasis Camping. Yep, so I think that's all the camping spots. All vehicle occupants must have a base gang and event wristband for entry. I don't know why they put that, because what if your wristband didn't get in the mail yet? That means that you're gonna have to go to will call, get your wristband, and then you can enter in the campground. So take note of that. If the first thing you do when you get to base gang is go get your festival wristband, that is one of the first things you need to do. Because it says that all vehicle occupants must have a base canyon event wristband for entry. So, can't get into campground unless you have your wristband. Okay, I think that's it. It shows the box office hours and location: Wednesday, 11 a.m. to 6 p.m., Thursday, 11 a.m. to 11 p.m., Friday, 11 a.m. to 11 p.m., 11, 11, 11, 11, all the way to Sunday. The camping box office can only assist with camping passes and other camping-related concerns. Camping box office hours: Wednesday, August 16th, 2023, 1 p.m. through Sunday, August 20th at 11 p.m. Cool. Bag policy for the amphitheater: bags must be clear, no longer than 12 inches by 12 inches by 6 inches. Non-clear hydration packs like camelbacks are okay. No backpacks larger than a camelback. Non-clear small clutches, fanny packs, and purses smaller than 6 by 9 are okay. Iridescent and tinted bags are not permitted. Permitted, they must be clear. Venue reentry: in years past, I think last year it was like VIP gets reentry, and depending on if they can, then everybody else might have reentry. They have stated that everybody gets reentry this year, so cool. Base Canyon is a cashless event, so if you have cash, they have stations where you can convert your cash and put it onto a card. Just don't lose that card, because it's essentially a debit card with all your fucking money on it. So that's usually what I do. Shuttles. Okay, so in the last video, I talked about the walk. There are shuttles from standard camping to the festival when you're going to the festival and when you're leaving the festival to go back. But when you're leaving the campgrounds, the shuttles go at like a constant rate when they start up to get you to the festival. You don't really have to wait for those. They're at different locations throughout the whole campground area. You'll be able to see, they have signage and everything so that you can find the closest one near you depending on where you're camping. You hop on the shuttle when it gets there, takes you to the festival entrance, and then, you get in line and you walk in. When you leave the festival each day, I'm pretty sure that everybody gets shuttles back, but like I said, there's thousands of people waiting in line to take the shuttle back. It is seriously just way quicker to follow that line of people back to camping, versus waiting for the shuttle. If you really don't want to walk, then take the shuttle. Base Canyon is a rain or shine event. Weather-wise, we are looking good. It is going to be hot. Drink water. When I was in the Army, I was deployed to Africa for 6 months. When I got there, it was 115 degrees with the heat index, humid as shit. I've put myself through the most intense heat situations. I promise you will be okay as long as you're drinking water. If you drink enough water, you don't have to worry about the heat. It'll be hot, but seriously, you'll be okay. Just drink a lot more water than you are alcohol and you'll be fine. It doesn't look like it'll rain. Still bring your rain gear, your rain clothing. Have it in your hydro pack. Throw it in your locker just in case. I've been subject to being screwed over because I'm an idiot in years past. Okay, I think that's all the info that I have. I hope this part two video was informative. I am super excited for the schedule and how everything lines up for day one, two, and three. I'm super excited for this year. If y'all want to meet up with me and spread that love and high energy, follow me on Instagram. I will be sending a message out to people, giving updates on my locations, for the pre-party, and if I'm in the campground area, if there's a big group of people that want to come hang out, then we'll make something happen. Just reach out to me. I've already had a lot of people reach out, and we're already making plans on what we're going to be doing. Big shout out all my base gang and homies. Very excited for this year. Yeah, year five base gang, and let's go. This is going to be the best base canyon yet, I already know. And thank you all for supporting me. I have some exciting news that I'm going to be dropping soon. I'll probably wait until after Base Canyon for that exciting news. When I start putting out, you know, festival sets and stuff. And I am going to be doing vlogs for Base Canyon this year. Starting the vlogging thing, I did that for EDC this year, and you know, the videos got some good reception. So I'm going to do my best to be doing, you know, a day one vlog, day two vlog, day three vlog, to have videos for each day that kind of bring you alongside the journey of what, you know, the whole day looks like. Not just posting, you know, sets for each artist that I saw, but also that whole vlog experience of, you know, all the homies that I'm chilling with and raging with and all that stuff. So keep an eye out for those videos. Keep an eye out for the exciting announcement that I will be making soon. And yeah, it's been saying my name, Soldier Guys. I'm trying to think if I'm going to end the video here. And if I think of anything else, I'll pop back in. If not, thank you all again. Can't wait to see y'all at Base Gang. And if you have any questions, just leave a comment below and I will do my best to answer them. Have a great day. I'll see you at Base Gang.
Oh my God, I'm so excited.
It's a good way to end day two.
Don't be a fool. Turn back.
Thank you.
with your homies and tell them that you're okay and how much you fucking love them and appreciate them.
Mine is
call
too.
Your fucking mom.
I'm trying to sing,
but most importantly, smoke as much weed as humanly fucking possible. I love you so fucking much. I'll be back soon.
Wow. Perfect.